Can you tell the difference between ba and ba, or da and da, or are you able to pronounce mongotwane? There are a lot, and I mean a lot of sounds that we use in speech. English, for example, has about 43, 44 sounds, a few more, a few less, depending on where you are from or where did you learn the language. And that applies to all languages. I, for instance, speak Spanish, and in my dialect from the north of Mexico, we have 5 vowels, I, U, E, O, A. But in Andalusia, in Spain, they tend to not say the plural S at the end of words. So you're probably gonna have a problem when you say things like libro and libros, book and books, because you will have book and book, libro, libro. So what did they came with? They changed their vowels. They have 3 more now. E, O, A. So instead of libros, el libro, it's a little bit open. Or for example, el lobo, los lobos, and in Andalusia would be el lobo, lo lobo. So even if you write the same letters, you're not gonna have the same amount of sounds. And you can say that you usually have more sounds than you have letters. And this applies to a lot of languages. Now imagine that there are languages that have 50 sounds, 60 sounds, 80 sounds. There are languages that have more than 100 sounds. But what are the strangest sounds in human languages? Back to the sounds at the beginning of the video, we have ba, 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 ba. Can you tell the difference? There's a little pause after the second p. Ba, 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 ba. It is probably because I'm not doing it very well. But K is easier. Ka, 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 ka. This little pause is called glottalization, and it can be performed after a lot of sounds. S-a, k-a, ch-a, t-a, k-a, ba-a. I think I repeated one. These are called ejective sounds, and they can be found in English at the end of some words. Stop, click, weak. But in English, these sounds are allophones of other consonants, which means that if you change the consonant, the meaning of the word stays the same. It has the same meaning if you say 1 week, 2 week, that if you say 1 week, 2 week. But these sounds can make a difference in other languages. Navajo, for example, where tsin means wood and tsin means bone. Or in K'ich language, where k'ich means our back and k'ich means the sun. This feature of making a changing meaning in words, it's called discretion, and makes the 2 sounds phonemes of a language, part of the repertory of discrete sounds. Now, this next type of sounds is kind of like ejectives, but instead of having that pause like when your glottis stops the airflow, now you have to kind of suck the air before you let go. That's why they're called implosives, because you make an implosion in your mouth. Da, 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 da. It's the same movement you do when you do a sound. And actually, a lot of English speakers do these sounds when they try to imitate someone drinking water. I'm making a lot of weird sounds for this video. An example of a language with one of these sounds is Yucatecan Mayan. You don't say balam, but balam, which means jaguar. Or in Jamaican Patois, the beginning of some words with ba, da, and ga. Bag, which means dog, and good, which means good. Yes, this is an English-based Creole language. But I'm pretty sure you're not familiar with the next set of sounds. Click sounds. As humans, we can do a lot of sounds with a vocal tract, but this doesn't mean that they are all linguistically relevant. Like when you yell of pain, or when you're imitating an animal, or imitating other sounds. But I just explained that an English speaker imitating someone drinking water can produce a sound that is relevant for another language. Now listen to this. That song is called Mongotwane, a traditional wedding song from the Xhosa people in South Africa. It was popularized by Miriam Makeba, whose introduction to the song always started with this discourse.
It's a wedding song back home where I come from. It's called by the English-speaking people the click song, because they cannot say Mongotwane.
Of course, part of the popularity of this song was the ecstaticity of the click sounds involved in it. Zulu and Xhosa are languages that are known for the click sounds in their inventory, like the dental, the lateral, or the alveolar. I'm doing my best. These are Bantu languages, which actually borrow their clicks from another linguistic family, the Khoisan languages. This family has more clicks like the bilabial or the palatal alveolar nga, 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 nga. Even though I just mentioned 5 types of clicks, there are languages like Ta, reported to have as few as 83 different click sounds in their inventory. And why so many? Because they have several ways to produce these sounds that I'm not even gonna try to pronounce. Also, I'd like to mention another language that is not exactly Bantu or Khoisan or related to any other click language. The Hadza language from Tasmania is an isolate language, which means that we don't know for sure what its linguistic family is. It's classified as endangered, which means that it can go extinct at any time soon. But the good thing is that some efforts have been done to make the language known and spread through social media. And I hope this effort makes the language stronger in the future. Now, probably after the click sounds, all other sounds probably sound vanilla now. But linguistically relevant sounds have way more to offer, and I would like to share with you my favorites. Pharyngeal fricatives. These I came across with when I was studying Arabic at the university. And what my teacher told me about them, I was fascinated by them. Arabic has two of these sounds. And of course, Arabic has letters for these sounds. Hal, which is not the English ha or the Spanish ja, it's actually in between. And probably you have heard this sound in the word habibi, which means my love. Habibi, ha, ha. The second one is ayn, which to me at first kind of sounded just like an a, a. But once you get to understand it, it changes your perspective about consonants, which Arabic did to me in general. And you know, that's the most famous word with that sound, al-arabiya, Arabic language. Arabiya, ah, ah. Trills. As a Spanish speaker, rolling my R's has never been a problem. Rápido corren los carros del ferrocarril. This sound is present in a lot of languages like Arabic. Rus, rice. But not only the alveolar trill exists. Rrr. There's the famous French rrr, sometimes trill in words like rendezvous. There's even a bilabial one, which sounds like someone's freezing. Bruh, bruh. I'm not really good with that one. But it's present in some languages like Piraha. Trills are a phenomenon that I just love because it doesn't just take an r to repeat itself several times to make a new sound. It's just some setting that a body finds to vibrate in a weird manner to somehow make a whole new sound. Lastly, I have the voiceless alveolar lateral affricate. Now in Mexico, we have a very famous language, spoken by the builders of the famous city of Teotihuacan. You know those Mesoamerican pyramids? The Aztec language has a very specific sound that I really love. Another name for the Aztec language is Nahuatl. And actually that last part is not originally tl, but tl. The name of the language in Nahuatl is Nahuatlatoli. You can hear that tl, tl, tl. And you know, tl is a compound sound. You can break it down into two parts, the tl and the tl. And actually, this sound sh, can be found in another languages that we already talked about in this video. Navajo, sha, which means some. Xhosa, sihlala, we stay. Even in Zulu, salangahle, which means stay well and is a way to say goodbye. And you know, in that one, I also have an implosive. Ga, salangahle. And also, phonetically speaking, a lot of sounds in Zulu are produced as ejectives, and they have the r sound present in some loan words. Meaning that in one language, you have present at least 5 of the phenomenon that I already talked in this video of strangest sounds. Meaning that if a sound is strange or exotic to us, doesn't actually make it weird or difficult to pronounce. It is just difficult for us who are not familiar with it. Every language have their own unique set of sounds. And somehow, we as humans find our way to learn these languages daily, be fluent, and speak them all over the world. And probably for someone somewhere, you speak one of the languages with the most unique and beautiful sounds they ever heard in their whole life. Think of that. So if you want more videos like this, please subscribe and leave a comment about the topic you would like to see next. Salaam alaikum.